cities are a product of time. So they flow. So they are like ecosystems, a little bit. We could imagine these systems of relations, but keeps changing. So people influence the space, and space is influenced by people, so it's a social relation. As we know, instinctively, as we work as urbanists, etc. If we are talking about space as a social relation, made of social relations or cultural relations, the question maybe is, like, can planning alone deal with this social-cultural ecosystem? Is it just the task of the planners, or should we confront this task as policymakers, as doers, if you want, with a different hat on, and maybe start thinking more about ourselves as less as professionals of placemaking, but enablers of social relations to happen. So what I'm saying is that it is very important that also planners, that they merge into the local life. So why don't we make thinkers, urban thinkers, planners, etc., embed themselves in a neighborhood a little bit more with a team of people as if you were living in that neighborhood to observe in an ethnographic way and then bring back the results to the table so that you can question your solutions, the solutions that you proposed. In a sense, what I'm saying, you need to challenge your professional knowledge if you really want to tackle this issue of how do we knit together neighborhoods that look otherwise segregated. I think what we are getting at is that a city that co-creates policies, development, etc., is a city that is really on a path to sustainable development and social development as well, I think. When you sit in an office, you're not just a number, you're not just there to fulfill your role, but you are really there to contribute, to enable the city to develop. So it's your mission. You're not just there to implement the rules or to create obstacles. They're really to enable this kind of cultural flow of ideas and creativity and implement it. I mean, at the top level, if your mindset is the mindset of the enabler, the helper, the mentor for the community, and not just the deliverer of a plan for the community, so then you'll be, in a sense, sitting with the local community, listening, and maybe contributing through your practice, through your professional experience, etc., contributing idea of how together you could deliver. And the local community, in turn, would feel that they have more confidence in dealing with the powers that be, because they don't see them anymore as abstract, distant, etc., but they see them more as a partner. I think that's the basis of democratic development. You know, that's the basis of how you make cities sustainable, where the wisdom of other people is welcome in a group when making a decision, etc. We do know scientifically also there have been studies that these kind of varied groups are more effective in helping decision making than the strictly speaking groups of professionals.